Good morning, everybody. Today now we are going to discuss about the transportation, the circulatory system. So in our body, so every organs need some blood, the needs they can get the energy. So this purpose, circulatory purpose, special one organ is there, that is known as that heart. In our body, where is located heart? Side. So we can see this heart is our fist size is there. Okay, we can see heartbeat equal to the pulse rate. Suppose if we are sick, the doctor first they can catch our wrist and they can see that. Pulse rate is there. Okay, pulse rate is equal to the heartbeat. For a minute, how many times heartbeat?
72.
How many times, sir?
72.
72 times per minute. So if we heartbeat is very high, we should consider as a different disease. If heartbeat is very low, it is considered as a different disease. So we can see this, okay, in our body, this heart is, you know, okay, heart is an important route that can supply the blood to the whole parts of our body. So this means how they supply the blood. So we can see this heart is known as pumping station in our body. So they can ask the question, okay, internal structure of the heart, as per the diagram, I explain easy. But they ask indirect question, indirect way they ask, okay, which organ is known as pumping station in our body? So this word if you don't know, the textbook is not this word. But this word if you don't know, Pompa's question if you know, but then you can unable to write. So this topic is very important. Why? Because veins and the heart, okay, 5 topics are there. So one if you listen that 5 topics are there, separate subject will ask. Internal structure of the heart, help us diagram and explain. Okay, what is the difference between arteries and veins? Okay, what is the difference between single circulation and double circulation? What is cardiac cycle? Okay, based on this heart only, same information, but you can separate should write. So first we know that the internal structure of the heart. If we are going to the, okay, internal structure of the heart, first lab activity is there. If you take it to the heart from the goat or sheep, okay, we can thoroughly wash and keep it the dry. So when we should, okay, when we have to observe that chambers, okay, how many blood vessels are there? First we have to observe that. So we can see heart is our fist size, they are located to the okay left side. So we can see here, we can hear the heartbeat. Okay, we can see lungs are there, but the left side lung is smaller than right side lung. Why? Because the heart is there spaced here. That's why the left side lung is smaller than the right side lung. So we can see our heart is the fist size is there. Okay, heart cut the 5 blood vessels are there. Okay, that we discuss later. Before that, okay, we can see heart is nothing is there. If they ask the foremost question, help of the diagram to explain the internal structure of the heart. Should draw the diagram. Only should write the 8 points or 10 points. What I can say that point wise you can write. First point, heart is known as pumping station of our body. Okay, heart is a wrap up with one membrane. Okay, that is called as a pericardial membrane. Heart is a wrap up with membrane. Pericardial
membrane.
So this pericardial membrane is then filled with one fluid. Okay, this heart is a with the pericardial membrane. Okay, this pericardial membrane filled with one fluid that is called as a pericardial fluid. Okay, pericardial fluid. So this pericardial fluid, it is suppose anybody suddenly hitting any shocks and jerks, if anybody hits suddenly near to the heart, they produce this fluid. Okay, first part, heart is known as pumping station of our body. Second part, heart is a manapa with a membrane that is called as a pericardial membrane. The pericardial membrane is filled with one fluid is called as a pericardial fluid. Okay, this pericardial fluid is a product from the heart, from the shocks and jerks. Next, okay, heart, okay, we can see the heart is a which shape is a pear shaped structure. Okay, fist size. But which size is there? So we can see this is the anterior, okay, anterior is there, posterior is, this is the narrow size is there, this is the very wide is there. This is somewhat big size is there, this is the narrow size is there. Okay, next we can see heart, actually they can, heart they have some muscles in this content, the coronary vessels are there, coronary vessels supply the blood from the heart muscles. Okay, mainly heart divided to the 4 chambers. How many chambers?
4 chambers.
So you can see this is the there. So easily 1, okay, 2, okay, 3 and another 4. Easy way we can explain here. This is the total point we can understand that. So heart has a four chambers. How many chambers?
Four chambers.
So four chambers. First we can correct it. Okay, upper chamber and another lower chamber. This is the two upper chambers. Two is the lower chamber. First we can classify as it two. Two upper chambers into lower chambers. Okay, upper chambers is called as a arteries. Okay, lower chambers is called as a ventricles. Clear? Here only confusion is there. This is the easy way. Like this also we can explain. But here you can get confusion. But this we can get clarity. This we can understand it easily. Okay, heart has four chambers. These four chambers we divide into the two. Okay, two upper chambers, two is the
lower chambers.
Upper chambers is called as a arteries, and again lower chambers is called as a ventricles. Okay, upper chambers and again lower chambers. Now these four chambers are we can divide as a okay lines. Okay, two right side chambers, two left side chambers. Here only confusion. First we can divide as arteries and ventricles. Now we can divide like this. Two left side chambers to right side chambers. Here you can see, okay, right anterior main again that one is the upper, one is the anterior, one is the posterior. One upper is the, one is the down is the right atrium, right ventricles. Left atrium, left ventricles. First we can classify as two upper chambers, lower chambers, arteries and veins. And again we should classify as the right side chambers and again left side chambers. So we can say right side two chambers is called as the right atrium, right ventricles. Left atrium and again the left ventricles. So we can see, okay, right side chambers are somewhat bigger than left side chambers. So like, okay. This is one side, this is one side. This you can see, right side contains the deoxygenated blood. Okay, deoxygenated blood. Okay, left side contains the oxygenated blood. Okay, oxygenated blood. Means this is a supply to the all the body parts. And again, this collect from the body parts to heart. Okay, right side chambers are there, left side chambers are there. Right side total deoxygenated blood, and again left side contain the oxygenated blood. Sir, here getting the doubt. Right, they are asking, sir, right side, left side is there. Is it deoxygenated and oxygenated? They can mix now, sir. So here, right side chambers and left side chambers separately, purpose separate, and there is that is called as a septum. Okay, that is called as a septum. Septum, they can separate the right side and another left side chambers. So you can see this side the deoxygenated blood, this side oxygenated blood. Up here clear. So next you can see. Okay, this right side chambers are much bigger than left side chambers. This is some big side here. This is the narrow side here. Okay, and again, okay, right atrium and again right ventricles. First to blood coming to the here body parts. Okay, here to enter that. Right ventricles to they go to the heart and heart to lungs and lungs to again heart to body parts. So you can see first here to here. So here to here how that only here separate valves are there. Okay, right atrium and again right to ventricle separating purpose. This separating purpose septum is here. This separating purpose here. Okay, this we can call as the right atrioventricular valves. This you can call as a left atrioventricular valves. So again, this is another name also is there. So this right side, right atrium and right ventricle separating purpose, separate one valves are there. That valves are called as a tricuspid valves. Which valves?
Tricuspid valves.
Tri means here three. Means this valves are contain mainly three portions like that, is three layers. So blood here to here opening here. Tricuspid valves. And again the left atrium and left ventricle separating purpose also valves are there. This is called as a bicuspid valves. Bi means two. So this is the three layers are there. Tricuspid valves. This is the bicuspid valves. Bicuspid valves. Another name is known as mitral valves. They ask the question. One more question they ask. How they ask it? In the heart, okay, how many valves are there? Where is the located? What is the function? Okay, tricuspid valves. Bicuspid valves. So we can see the four chambers. Up here, clear na?
Yes.
Okay, four chambers to upper chambers to right chambers to left side chambers to right side chambers. Right atrium, right ventricle. Left atrium, left ventricles. Deoxygenated blood, oxygenated knowledge. Clear up to here? So you see, now we'll enter to the main topic. Okay? Based on this only 5-6 points you can write. Upper chambers, lower chambers, right side, left side, deoxygenated, oxygenated. Now enter to the heart. What is the size of the heart?
Fist size.
So you can fist size there. Heart also contains the 5 blood vessels. How many blood vessels?
5
blood vessels. Main here. Each blood vessel 1 point. Heart is the fist size. If you forget it also, remember this is the fist. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So heart also contains the 5 blood vessels. So one is called as an aorta. Okay, one is called as a pulmonary artery. One is called as a pulmonary veins. One is called as a superior
vena cava.
One is called as a
inferior vena cava.
Shortcut you should remember. So this blood vessels means blood supply. So where to get the supply? Okay. So we can see 5 is there. This somewhat thick is there. So this is the inner the heart, which is the largest blood vessel. One more question I will ask. Which is the largest blood vessel? Aorta is the largest blood vessel in the heart. Aorta is the largest blood vessel in the heart. So this you can see here. Okay, here to the supply the blood to the body parts. Okay, aorta is the supplying the oxygenated blood from heart to body parts. Aorta is supplying the blood from heart to
body parts.
Heart to body parts. This is the largest blood vessel in the heart. Okay, aorta is the largest blood vessel in the heart. Supply the blood from heart to
body
parts. Clear. Next, pulmonary V, pulmonary artery. Okay, pulmonary artery supply the blood from heart to lungs. Okay, heart to
lungs.
Which blood? Deoxygenated
blood.
Deoxygenated blood. Suppose one circulation completed, blood go into body, again coming to the heart. So we can see aorta will supply the blood from heart to body parts, and again pulmonary artery supply the blood from heart to lungs. So pulmonary veins are there. Pulmonary veins supply the blood from lungs to heart. Okay, lungs to heart. So we can see this is the deoxygenated blood, heart to go to the lungs. With the breathing respiration time, we can take the oxygen back to the blood, and the oxygen blood again heart to lungs to again came to the heart. Then carry the pulmonary veins, then carry the blood from lungs to heart. Next you can see superior vena cava. Okay, superior vena cava, they collect the blood from upper portion like head to heart. Head to heart. Okay, upper portion. Okay, we can see superior vena cava is there here. Superior vena cava, okay, inferior vena cava, okay. Okay, superior vena cava, they collect the blood from heart to head to heart. And inferior vena cava means they collect from the down portion. Okay, like a legs, okay, legs and again hands. Okay, this down portion is blood collected from the heart. So separate vessel is there. That is called as a inferior vena cava. Okay, we can see 5 blood vessels are there in the heart. One is called as a aorta, pulmonary artery, pulmonary veins, superior vena cava,
inferior vena cava.
Okay, which is the largest blood vessel in the heart?
Aorta.
Aorta is the largest blood vessel in the heart. Supply the blood from heart to body parts. Pulmonary artery supply the blood from
heart to lungs.
Pulmonary veins from the blood from
lungs to heart.
Superior vena cava collect the blood from
head to heart.
Inferior vena cava collect the blood from the
heart.
So 5 blood vessels, 5 points. About the 4 chambers, 4 points. About the heart, which shape, which muscles are there, like that we can write. So in the base of the heart, they can ask me as a systole. Okay, next you can ask as a diastole. Okay, heart is showing to the okay one contraction is there, relaxation is there. Contraction means blood is pushing to the body parts. Relaxation means supply the blood from the body parts to heart. Contraction is there, relaxation is there. Heart is the 24 hours working. Valve means baby cam also heartbeat is there. heart beat is stopping, nothing but the person is
dead.
Correct or not? So we can see this is the okay pumping station. Pumping is always pumping. Contraction is there, relaxation is there. Left up sound is there. Correct or not? We can consider it. Okay, systolic and again
diastolic.
Systolic pressure, diastolic pressure. That we can consider as 120/80. Okay, this is considered BP. BP means
blood pressure.
Okay, normal blood pressure 120/80. Normal heartbeat 72 times per minute. Okay, 1 minute is 72 times. So heartbeat is very high. So heart is supplying blood very fast. Fast to sudden stop. Heart attack they're getting, heart attack like that. So you can see his arteries are very strong. Okay, arteries are very strong. Why? Because they can supply blood from to the okay, then ventricles arteries are very strong. Okay, they can based on this. Okay, the systolic pressure and diastolic pressure. Systolic means contraction. Blood is pushing to the body parts. Okay, diastolic pressure is a relaxation. Blood is observing from the body parts to heart. Okay, pushing and observing. Contraction, relaxation, left, down. Okay, next systole and another diastole. Okay, this is based on this one. Next, you can see single circulation is the double circulation is there. Single circulation means blood is completely one circulation is reached to the heart. It's once is called as a single circulation. Single means it won't reach to the heart only one time. The double circulation means one circulation completing purpose, completing time, they can reach to the heart twice. So first blood is coming to the heart. Heart they're going to the lungs. Again lungs to again coming to the heart. Again going to the body parts. Two times they're coming. So this is considered as a double circulation. Single circulation example fish. Okay? Single circulation example fish. Okay, fish they can directly coming. Why? Because they can respiratory organs, gills. They live in the water. They can take it to the oxygen, dissolve oxygen, again they're setting. But remaining human beings double circulation example human being double circulation example human beings. So single circulation again another double circulation. Systolic pressure again another diastolic pressure. They ask one more question. What is the difference between arteries and veins? Okay, what is the difference between arteries and again
veins?
Arteries and another
veins.
Okay. So this also easy only based on the heart only. Okay, arteries means to supply the blood. Which blood they can supply? Where to where they supply the artery? They supply the heart to body parts. Okay, arteries always carry the blood from heart to
body parts.
Okay, next veins carry the blood from body parts to heart. Body parts to
heart.
Okay, arteries they carry the always oxygenated blood. Oxygenated blood. They can carry the always deoxygenated
blood.
Okay, arteries are thicker than veins. This is very strong, is there? Because oxygen pushing up diastolic systolic pressure is there. This is stronger than veins. Okay, diameter also is there. What is the difference between arteries and veins? Suppose they ask the what is between veins and arteries, the same points they write. We can think question first what they ask. Arteries, veins. Differentiation also they ask. Systole, diastole also they ask. Internal structure of the heart. Means you can write one paragraph figure. 2-3 pages you can write. Matter is there. Okay, this is about that internal structure of the heart. Okay, we can see heart is known as pumping station in our body. So heart has a how many chambers?
Four chambers.
Okay, that is called as the right atrium, right ventricles,
left atrium, right ventricles.
Okay, tricuspid walls are there. Bicuspid walls. Bicuspid walls. Another name. Mitral
walls.
How many blood vessels are there?
Five.
What is called that?
Aorta, pulmonary artery, capillary,
and inferior. The largest blood vessel is called as aorta. The smallest blood vessel is called as
pulmonary artery.
This is a strong blood vessel. This is the veins are. Okay, they only collect it. Pushing, pumping station of body is one of that. Heart. I thought the diagram will be explained. Is it clear?
Yes, okay. Sir.
Thank you.